When counting cards, what's the most valuable spot at the table to sit? I'm going to break down the math of that question as well as a few considerations for the next time you hit the blackjack tables. An inevitable question when someone gets into card counting is, where at the table should I sit, or does it even matter? So first, let's look at the expected value. I ran a whole bunch of simulations to see the difference in win rate or expected value of sitting first or sitting in the middle of the table or sitting last to act at the blackjack table. And the bottom line is, for a shoe game, meaning a 6 or 8 deck game, there's absolutely no measurable difference to sitting first, in the middle, or sitting last. In a double deck game, however, there's a very small, I'm talking 1 to 2, less than 2% difference if you are playing last compared to if you are playing first. This is what I was expecting, because I remember hearing very early on as a card counter that when you play last, you get a little bit more information by seeing other players' cards from when they hit or split or double down or whatever, that you can take that extra information. It's gonna make your playing decisions a little bit more accurate, but it's a very small increase in EV. So the academic answer is that it's slightly more valuable to play last in double deck, and it really doesn't matter in a shoe game. But don't overthink this. We're likely talking about pennies per hour, and there are a lot of other ways to generate a lot more than 1 to 2% more EV. If you wanna generate another 1 or 2% EV, play 1 or 2 more hands at the end of the hour or the end of the night. Better yet, rather than playing last at a table with multiple other players, you're way better off playing a less crowded table, because you're gonna get in way more rounds per hour if it's a less crowded table than a more crowded table. And I'm talking about twice as many, like 100% increase in EV or even a 200% increase in EV. But beyond the EV, there are a few other things you might wanna consider. The first of which is, if you're new to card counting, it can actually be helpful to sit first. And the reason why is because when you're first to act, you have as much time as you need to update the running count. The dealer cannot deal until you make a playing decision, and you might feel awkward if you're sitting there at first base and they're saying, do you want to stand or hit? And you're saying, hold on. But the reality is, you have as much time as you need. And what can happen is, if you're playing last and you don't have the count in time and this guy at first base starts hitting his hand and he busts and they're taking cards off the table, you're getting behind on the count. You're actually missing out on cards. And so my advice is, early on, sit at first base, take your time, and control the speed of the game so that you can actually count accurately. So another consideration is that if you're gonna play third base, which is the last to act, it's kind of stupid, but you have to be prepared to get a little bit more flack from the other players. There's this false gambler logic that your playing decisions impact the whole table, and that's not true. You can run computer simulations and there's no measurable impact. Your playing decisions don't affect the other player's odds. Yeah, sometimes your decision makes everyone lose, sometimes your decision makes everybody win, but it doesn't affect the odds of the game. But don't tell a gambler that, because they believe that third base is the anchor. They're responsible for the whole table winning or losing. It's stupid, it's not logical, but that's what they think. So if you're gonna play third base, be prepared for someone to say, hey, you screwed up the dealer's hand. And you know, my advice is to ignore them, but if you just wanna avoid that flack altogether, just sit somewhere else. And one final consideration is, if you sit at first base, keep your eyes out, because there are times when you can catch a glimpse of the dealer's bottom card. And if you know how to use that information, it can be a piece of information to use as a card counter. I'm not talking about shuffle tracking here, but if you've been to one of our blackjack boot camps, you likely know what I'm talking about, because it's something I always cover during a boot camp. It's a small bit of information, but it's still a bit of information that can be used for your advantage. So here's the deal. Sitting at first base or at the middle or at third base, the last spot, that's not the difference between being a successful card counter and an unsuccessful card counter. There's really very little measurable difference, if any, where you sit. What does make you a successful card counter is perfect basic strategy, perfect counting, perfect betting and true count conversion, and knowing the playing deviation so that you can have a strong edge against the casino. If you want to learn more about beating casinos with blackjack, you can subscribe to this YouTube channel And you can also check out blackjackapprenticeship.com, where for 10 years now, we've been training people how to beat casinos legally with card counting for real money.